If one man has two eyes, then two men has 2 × 2, 4 eyes. Then 7 men has 7 × 2, that is 14 eyes. And so on, if we consider P man, that P is unknown number. If we consider P equals to 1000, P equals to 200, whatever may be, then P × 2, that is 2P eyes. So here, P is an unknown number here. Its change belongs to this quantity of P. So generally, algebra is a branch of mathematics that deals with the numbers expressed as generalized symbol such as x, y, z, etc. Here, x, y, z are the useful alphabets in algebra. That's why we commonly used x, y, z here. We also used all the alphabets for algebra. Now, say that, for example, we may say that someone has a sum of rupees x when we mean that a person has certain sum of money. We cannot say that the amount, but we can say that a certain sum of money he has. Okay, now this quantities is not fixed. That's why it is called variables. The quantity is not fixed. That's why this is called variables. So this is called variables. Now see the operations. If 5 and x are two different numbers, then in addition we can say that 5 plus x means 5 plus x is not a fixed number. X is not fixed here. So we consider the sum of 5 and x is 5 plus x. Similarly, the subtraction of 5 and x is 5 minus x. Division 5 by x and multiplication 5 into x. That is 5x. Now, if we multiply two same type of variables, that is x and x, then we consider x square. Okay, x and square. So here this is 2. How many times? This is 1 and this is 1. So 1 plus 1, this is 2. If 3 times, then this is 3. Because 1, 1 and 1. 1 plus 1 plus 1, this is 3. This is for multiplication also. We also previously discussed plus and 2 plus. That is plus, minus into plus, that is minus, plus into minus, that is minus, and minus into minus, that is plus. These rules are very important for our this exercise. Now we are considering many terms can be combined in addition or subtraction to form an algebraic expression. In fact, a single term may also be considered as an expression. So firstly, monomial. So what is a monomial? Monomial means when single term is there. So minus 8, a, x cube, 3xy. So this type of single term, when we are writing a single term, so this is called monomial. What is binomial? Binomial means two term. That is 3 plus x, x plus y, 5 plus z, okay, xy plus 1. So these are binomial. See that the two terms is there. Subtraction or multiplication, you can both can write. Okay. So binomial means two terms when there, and monomial means when single term is there. So similarly, trinomials means three terms is there. Suppose 10 plus x minus y, three terms, x plus y minus 2, x plus y plus z. So three terms is there. So this is called trinomial. And if 4, 5, this is called multinomial. Multinomial. Okay. When greater than two terms is there, we can say that multinomial. Now, in these expressions, see that these are constant, these are variables, x, y, these are variables, but these 10, 2, these are constant term. So here, x is variable and 3 is constant term. Here, z is variable, 5 is constant term. Okay, here x, y is variable and 1 is constant term. Now, we are going to discuss about coefficient and like and unlike terms. So, what is coefficient? Suppose, I am writing minus 3x. So, coefficient of x is minus 3. Coefficient of x is minus 3. Similarly, 3z. So, coefficient of z is 3. 1 by 4 t. So, coefficient of t is 1 by 4. Similarly, if we write 5xy, coefficient of y is 5x. Coefficient of, from here also, coefficient of x is 5y. Coefficient of xy is 5. Okay, so this is the coefficient of the terms. Now, like and unlike term. When the variables are same, this is called like term. Suppose 5x and 7x are like term. Because when the like term is there, you can add and subtract with the like terms. Multiplication with the any terms, like or unlike. But you add or subtract only in the like terms. So 5x plus 7x, that means 12x. But if given 5x plus 7y, then you cannot add it because the variables are different here. So we add only when the like variable are there. Now, for the unlike term, this is also an example of the unlike term. You see that 5x and 7y are unlike term. If we add it, we cannot add. Only you can write 5x plus 7y, but we cannot write 12xy. Okay. Similarly, for subtraction also, minus 7y and 2y. So if we add it, we get minus 5y. Okay. Why minus 5y? Because see that minus 7y plus 2y. Which is the big number here? Minus, sorry, 7. So, what sign? Minus. So, 7 minus 2 is 5. So, minus 5y. We are subtracting because the variable are like. Okay. When this is z or the, any other variable, then we cannot add or subtract between two variables. Now, we are discussing about polynomial and degree. So, algebraic expression whose terms are powers of the literal x or constant is called polynomial. In x, the greatest among the indices of the power of x in the terms of the polynomial is called degree of the polynomial in x. For example, if 2 plus x, so the power of x is 1. So, the power of the x is 1. That means degree is 1. The degree is 1. And it is polynomial equation. Why it is polynomial equation? Because this is a linear equation. Linear equation. When the power of x is 1, this is linear equation. Next, we can write here 2 plus 2x plus x square. So here see that the power of x, the highest power of x is 2. That means degree is 2 here. And this type of equation, when the highest power is 2, this is called quadratic equation. Quadratic equation. Okay. When the power is 2, this is called quadratic equation. This is not in your syllabus, just for information I am telling you. when the power is 2, that means this is called quadratic equation. And similarly, see that 2 plus 3x plus 3x square plus x cube. So when the highest power is 3, so many powers are there, 2 here, 1 here, but we only see that the highest power. So highest power is 3. That means degree is 3. And this type of equation when the power is 3 is called cubic equation. Cubic equation. Okay, this is called cubic equation. Now, we are starting our exercise 1A of algebra. In A1, see that the sum of 3 and A. So, sum of 3 and A means 3 plus A. The sum of M and N, that is M plus N. A is subtracted from 2, that means 2 minus A. Next, number 9. 3 times the sum of x and 5. So 3 into x plus 5. You can do number 7 also. The product of 11 and p. That is 11p. This is number 7. The product of 11 and p. This is 11p. Next. Number 10, the sum of y and minus 7. The sum of y and minus 7, that means y minus 7. Why y minus 7? Because, see that, if y plus minus 7 we are writing, plus into minus, this is minus, so y minus 7. So y minus 7 divided by 11. Okay? Next, number 11, see that, the product of 3 and the product of 3 and the difference between x and 2, x is greater. Okay, so x minus 2 into 3. Now in number 2, fill in the blanks given. A plus A plus A plus A plus A, that means how many A is there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So 5A is there. So 5A. But when multiplication is there, so x into x into x into x into x, that means x to the power 5. So 5x, that means multiplied. So if 2 into 2, that means, 2 into 2 into 2, that means 2 to the power cube, that means 8. But if 2 plus 2 plus 2, then this is 6, mind it. So if x into x into x into x, that means x to the power 5. How many x is there? 1 into 2, 3, 4, 5. So x to the power 5. But when you add, that means a plus a plus a plus a plus a, that means 5a. How many a is there? 5. So 5a. And here you are writing the index. Okay. This is the index. And this is the base. I am coming in this part. So next, number 5. Y divided by z. That means y by z. So we can write here y into 1 by z. So this is number 1 and 2. In number 3, see that find the base and the index. Index also can call power. So x cube. X cube base is x and power or index is 3. Similarly, 2 and 3 same. Number 4, 2y to the power 5. Here base is 2y. And power is 5. Now, 4 and 5 are same. Number 5 I am doing. So, number 5, see that for an algebraic expression, 1 plus 3 by 4x minus 4 by 3y plus xy. So, here you have to find how many terms are there in the expression. So, see that 1, 2, 3, 4. How many terms are there? 4 terms. Now, next question. write the terms of the expression. So I am writing here 1, 3 by 4 x minus 4 by 3 y and x y are the terms here, and the constant term is 1. Now find the sum of the coefficient of literals x and y. So 3 by 4 for x and minus 4 by 3 for y. So see that 3 by 4 minus plus minus minus, so minus 4 by 3. After calculating we get minus 7 by 12. Now next problem. In number 6, you have to write the terms, that is monomial, binomial or trinomial. I am denoting B for binomial, M for monomial and T for trinomial. So see that in 6 1, 10x plus 5, so this is binomial, minus 4x squared, this is monomial, x plus x, 1 plus x plus x squared, this is trinomial, a into b, very important part, a into b, if we say that, how many a is there, 2, so that's why this is a square, see that, 2a, a into a, that means a square, and b, only b, so how many a is there, so a into a, that means a square, and a plus a means 2a, don't forget, so a into a means a square, that is b, and b is there, okay, so a square b, a single term, that is monomial, don't write this is trinomial, okay, maximum students are doing wrong about that, writing wrong about that, so a into a plus into b, that means a square b, this is monomial. Now a square plus b square plus 1, this is trinomial, and a into 1 by b, this is also a into 1 by b, that means a by b, this is a monomial, okay. Now in number 7, see that 15x. So you have to find the numerical factor and literal factor. Literal factor means algebraic, that is variable. So here see that 15x, numerical factor is 15, literal is x, 2 by 9 ab squared. That means 2 by 9 is a numerical factor, literal factor is ab squared. Similarly, minus a square, that means numerical factor is minus 1, that means minus 1 into a square, that means minus a square. So literal means literal factor is a square. Similarly, in 8, you have to find the coefficient of x. So coefficient of x, here the coefficient of is minus half, here coefficient of x 2y, here the coefficient of x is minus 5 a square. Okay. Here the coefficient of b square, that means minus a, 7a square and minus 8c. Now in number 10, see that you have to find the like terms of the following groups. Now firstly, without seeing the numbers, see the coefficients and variables. So here variables is x, xy and y. For similar variables is x and x, that means these are like terms. Similarly see that x square, x, xy, so these are same, so x square and 11 by 9 x square, so these are same. Next, 8 a square b, 8 ab square minus 10 ab square, 1 by 7 a square, so see that ab square, so 8 ab square and minus 10 ab square are like terms. So like means the variable are same, okay, so like means the variable are same. Now next, for your informations, algebraic expression are polynomial in literal terms, that means is not contains 1 by x 1 by x square, 1 by x cube, 1 by y, 2 by z like terms. These terms in a algebraic expression or monomial or trinomial, this is not a literal term. Suppose, for example, 3 plus 1 by x is literal term? Answer, no. But if we say 3 plus x is literal term, the answer is yes. So this type of term, when in an algebraic expression, this expression is not a literal term. Okay, this is a literal term, this is a non-literal term. See that in 11, which of the following algebraic expression are polynomials in a literal? So see that number 2, 5x square minus 7x plus 3 by x. So just I am discussing, when these type of term is there, this is not literal. Okay, this is not literal term. Number 3, 7 minus y square, this is a literal term? Yes. Next, number 5, 1 by 8x plus 1 by 9, it's a literal term or non-literal term? It's a literal term because the variable is not in the form 1 by. Okay, variable is not in the form 1 by. Here the numbers in the form 1 by. Okay, next number 4. This is 1 by x plus x. So this is 1 by x. See that? Here only x is there. Here 1 by x. That means it is non-literal terms. Next, in number 12, just you have to write the degree of the polynomial. So in number 1, see that x plus 2 degree is 1 because the power of the x is 1. In number 3, say that 7 minus y square, what is the degree? 2, because the power is 2 here. Next, number 4, y cube minus y plus 1, so highest is 3, so degree is 3. Okay, so this is the first part of the algebra, and in the next class we will discuss about the substitution and value putting part. Hope you all enjoy this class. Thank you all, and the rest of the work is homework. Please send your homework and give me some time for checking. Thank you all. Take care. Stay home, stay safe.